गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी रिवाइज्ड फर्स्ट पोयम ऑफ योर फ्लेमिंगो बुक एंड द नेम ऑफ पोयम इज माय मदर एट 66 एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज द सेकेंड पोयम and the name of poem is an elementary school classroom in Islam. Dear students, this second poem, an elementary school classroom in Islam, is composed by one of the renowned English poets and writers, Mr. Stephen Spender, who was born in 1909, and he was a well-known English poet and essayist. Mr. Spender worked as a poet and essayist, और ही लेफ्ट यूनिवर्सिटी कॉलेज ऑक्सफोर्ड विदाउट टेकिंग एनी डिग्री और ही वेंट टू बर्लिन। लेटर ऑन ही वर्क एज ए सोशलिस्ट और एज ए पेसिफिस्ट। मिस्टर स्टीफन स्पेंडर हैज रिटन मेनी एसेज, many poems, but he used to write on one important and specific issue, and that is social injustice, that is social inequalities. So Mr. Stephen Spender is famous for writing the poems on social inequalities and social injustice. This was all about Mr. Stephen Spender. Dear students, before starting the line by line explanation of this poem, one question is given in your poem, in your book, और द पोयम, द क्वेश्चन इज कि हैव यू एवर विजिटेड आर सीन एन एलिमेंट्री स्कूल इन इस्लाम, व्हाट डज इट लुक लाइक। तो योर आंसर विल बी कि दैट मेनी टाइम्स वी हैव विजिटेड an elementary school running in slum areas, but actually the condition is very very severe. Condition is not good. There is not proper ventilation. There is not proper light in the classrooms. There is no arrangement of drinking water. So finally and ultimately you may say ki many times we have visited primary schools, elementary schools, or their condition is not good, or actually they look like hell. Or in this circumstances children cannot get proper education. This poem, an elementary school classroom in Islam, composed by Mr. Stephen Spender, is on social inequalities and on social injustice. Poet Stephen Spender wants to highlight, wants to tell us, wants to tell the people that how a major section of the society, children are getting very low facility, and how the rich and aristocrat people, their children, how they are getting a better facility. So this is the matter of social inequalities and social injustice. Their children, their sons and daughters are studying in exclusive public school. But the children who are living and spending their life in slum areas, in low economic standard areas, they are forced to study in such low facility schools, low standard schools. Or in such schools, proper education is not possible. Dear children, this particular poem is divided in four parts. In first part and in first stanza, the poet Stephen Spender is trying to tell the condition of students who are studying in elementary classroom running in slum areas. Poet Stephen Spender says in the first stanza, and he describes ki the children who are sitting and studying in elementary school classroom running in slum areas, they are far away from nature. They are far away from gusty waves. Or the children who are studying in elementary classroom, school classroom, their faces are yellowish and pale. Or on their yellowish faces, their hairs are spread just like the rootless weeds. As they have not properly combed their hairs, the children, the students who are sitting and studying in elementary classroom, their hairs are spread on their yellowish forehead just like the rootless weeds. The poet wants to tell that the children are far away from nature and they are not getting any facility. They are not getting proper food and nutrition which is required to them, which is very, very important to them. Or he tells firstly about the first student, or the first student of that classroom, elementary classroom running in slum area, is a tall girl. She is ill. She is depressed. She is tired and exhausted. Her head has been bent due to not getting proper food and nutrition, due to illness and exertion. This is the condition of first student. The second student is a boy, or he is very, very thin. Or his body organs are not properly developed, underdeveloped. He is as thin as paper. Children used to call him a paper boy. Here metaphor poetic device has been used, means that child, that boy is, that second student is very, very thin. As you cannot say he was, but as thin as paper, but he was very, very weak, very, very thin. Or his body organs are not properly developed, even his eyes are very, very small, as small as red size of, again metaphor poetic device. So what I want to tell you, dear children, ki that particular boy, that particular student, second student who is sitting and studying in elementary classroom, his body organs are not properly developed. Not only this much, he has got one disease which was gifted and given to him by his parents. His parents were also suffering from Bones disease, or the same disease they transferred in that child. But that child, unfortunate child, is reciting his lesson, his poem, his lesson from his desk. That malnourished child, he's reciting his lesson. So this is the condition of second student. And third student is a cute boy, is a sweet boy, who is sitting in the class but dreaming something and dreaming the game, and he's in his dream, he is busy in game of squirrel. In that dream, the squirrels are running on the different branches of the trees. So this is the condition of students sitting and studying in elementary classroom, running in slum areas, running in low economic standard areas. This is the first part. And in second part, dear children, the poet further says that what is the, he describes in the second part the condition of classroom. He says that the walls of the classrooms are not whitewashed for a long time. The walls are faded. Sour cream walls, colorless walls. Or on these walls, two gifted items are displayed. One is the picture of great dramatist and poet Mr. William Shakespeare, who is symbol of education and learning, composed many poems and written many plays. And the third one is a map which is describing the actual picture of the world. Tireless valley, big buildings spread in the different parts of the cities, and that map is actually awarding and giving the actual picture of the world. But for these children who are sitting in elementary classroom, school classroom, their world is this packed classroom, not that world which is given in that map. Or these children are far away from rivers, from far away from caves, natural places. So for these children, this packed and dark and dirty classroom is their world. Or here in the map, there is a cloudless at dawn. But here their life is full of fog, full of unclarity. Their future is not clear. So this is given in the second stanza. And in third stanza, the poet Stephen Spender further says ki the two gifted items which have been displayed on the sour cream walls of this elementary classrooms, they are the bad examples. Map is also bad example, and that picture of great dramatist and poet Mr. Shakespeare's also a bad example. Because in such limited resources, they cannot become great dramatist and poet like Mr. William Shakespeare. They cannot get education. Or the picture, the big buildings and the neat and clean atmosphere which was shown in the map is also not giving any lesson to them. It is also a bad example. Instead of giving any lesson, these things are attracting the children sitting in elementary classroom for stealing alluring them for stealing. So these things are not beneficial. They are bad example. The children are not learning anything from these things. He further says ki the children who are living and studying in such areas and in such schools, their lives have been cunningly and cleverly turned into the packed and dark and dirty classrooms, or their life is here as unclear as fog, or their bones are peeping in further line. The poet says that their bones are peeping through their skins. On their slag heap, these children wear the skins peeped through by the bones. Means the children are very, very thin. Due to that, their bones are clearly visible. Not only this much, their eyesights have also become very, very weak, dear children. And in this small age, the children are forced to wear spectacles, steel-rimmed spectacles. Or the condition of glasses are also not good. Condition of glasses which have been used in their spectacles is not good. That is mended and repaired glasses. Or how it looks like, how the glasses are looking like, as any bottle has been fallen from the top to the on the stone, and after falling many cracks are seen. In the same way, dear children, the glasses which have been used in their spectacles, they are not in good condition. They are mended and repaired. Those children are living and surviving in such poor condition. Here their future is full of fog. Their life starts from rubbish and it ends in rubbish. So poet finally and ultimately suggests in the last line ki remove this map from the classrooms, or as big as doom, as big as destruction. Remove all these things. Or finally, dear children, in last stanza, poet appeals to all the authorities, to governors, to inspector and to visitors, ki until and unless this map becomes their windows in place of this map, there should be big windows. Then they will get the proper ventilation, proper light, and they will be able to concentrate themselves in the classrooms and in their studies. Poet further says, because these things have been shut in, and these things have definitely closed their lives in this packed classroom, or their lives are just like catacombs, underground burial place. Or finally, dear children, so these things have closed all the things, all the opportunities of their life, or they are living a very miserable life, children living and studying. So finally, he appeals to the authorities that to break and destruct all these localities and all these schools, and take these children living in such low economic standard areas to the nature and show them the beauty of nature and give them proper food and nutrition. Or when they will run on the sands and they will live in the contact of nature, so their mind will be refreshed. Or when they will run under the blue sky on the sands, और व्हेन देयर स्टमक विल बी फुलफिल्ड व्हेन दे विल गेट द प्रॉपर न्यूट्रिशंस सो एंड इन दैट कंडीशन इफ द बुक्स विल बी गिवन टू देम तो दे विल क्रिएट हिस्ट्री हिस्ट्री दस हिस्ट्री विल बी दस और द लैंग्वेज इज द सन एंड देन दियर लैंग्वेज विल बी एज ब्राइट एज सन दियर फ्यूचर विल बी एज ब्राइट एज सन बट इन सच सर्कमस्टेंसेज इन सच लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल डियर चिल्ड्रन So this is the appeal of Mr. Stephen Spender. This issue he wants to highlight. I hope you have understood all four parts. Thank you, dear children.